Good afternoon, audience. My name is Kimberly Harris, and I am sitting here with the honor of interviewing two queens for the Journey of a Queen documentary, Queen Pandora Love and Queen Corlin Fingers.
Hey.
And Queen Fingers, we like to say happy birthday to you.
Thank you.
Yes. You beautiful, beautiful. So, ladies, tell me, individually, but tell me, how did you both get involved in this
pageant?
You go first.
You're the birthday girl.
Oh, my goodness. Miss Jennifer, she honestly, like, on the random, kind of was like, hey, just want to let you know you've been nominated. And I was like, huh? I was like, nominated?
Surprise.
Right, like, real big surprise. And I was like, oh. So, honestly, like, because of her.
Same here. Like, you know, I stay on Facebook and I just got the inbox. Like, you've been nominated. I'm like, oh, for what? Right. But yeah, from Miss Jennifer.
But you see, Miss Jennifer, she saw something in the both of you. So she just brought it out to light.
Yes, right? Ma'am.
Wonderful. So tell the listening audience individually about your background.
Your turn. You go first.
Really?
Yes, we're about to tag team.
All right, so I'm Pandora Love. I'm first. I'm a radio personality. I started out at NDC Radio, but right now I'm with WeAreGoGoMusic.com. I'm also a licensed cosmetologist and esthetician. And I just, well, an activist, and I'm so much. So I'm like a lady of all
trades. All things.
So, I'm just everywhere.
So that's what makes you the queen you are?
Yes, I'm just everywhere.
Well, my background, pretty much majority dancer for the last 25 years? 25, 26. Currently going to school to get my cosmetology license. I currently dance with Catherine Smith, which I've been with her for like the last, I started with her in 2006, so it's like I've traveled with her, where she goes, I go. I've danced with Philadango, like Dango 2, Soul in Motion, just pretty much my passion has just always been dance, with like the side hustle of like wanting to do hair.
So, well, we knew you were in the field of beauty because that whole face is just glowing. Your whole face is just glowing. This beautiful mixture of color. I just love it. What is, in today's society, we talk a lot about unity, coming together as a people, but we as women, what would you both say would be the number one key factor that we should practice in supporting one another?
I would say just liking, not judging. We need to stop judging each other. You know, like me and one of the other queens was talking, you know, just because you might work at a government job and I work at Shoe City, don't mean you're no better than me. So no matter where we're from, where we live, where you live, where I live, nobody's really no better than another.
Because we can all learn from each other.
Because we all can learn from each other.
Oh, I agree. The way she worded it, I was gonna say pretty much like just accepting differences and accepting and embracing somebody's difference. Because at the end of the day, you don't know what kind of connection you may have with somebody, and you could very well block your blessing from somebody that you feel, oh, they're different than me. I don't want to. No, like embrace somebody that's different than you.
Because God made us different, right? Different.
Yes, ma'am.
That's right. Blessed us with all this talent and gifts. What would you both say would be the key encouraging words of wisdom to young girls that are watching you and your audience today?
I would say in this generation, they need to learn to humble themselves and listen. Listening and every everybody's not against you. Everybody's not out to hurt you. There's some people that genuinely care about your well-being, whether they know you or not. So just humble yourself sometimes.
I think me being like from somewhat the younger generation, I feel like it's understanding that people who are older than you or people who have come before you a lot of times are out to hurt you. So I think just, you know, like even piggybacking off of what Pandora said, just knowing, one, how to humble yourself, because a lot of times this generation doesn't even know what humbleness means.
Right.
Understanding the difference between what is portrayed on TV and social media, that it's not a lifestyle. It's me basically portraying how I want you to see me, and understanding that not everything that you see is 100. Right. People walk around talking about, oh, I'm 100. What is 100? What's considered being 100? Authenticity is what's 100. When you can be you and you can live your life unapologetically, not caring what nobody else thinks.
You're so right. Living life on your terms. Yes. The wonderful, wonderful encouragement that Dr. Newsome has given you both, and the shining light that he's been, what are some of the other attributes that you've learned from him during this whole process?
For me, well, I had the pleasure of interviewing him. And from that interview, I learned to don't accept no. You know, stand up for what I mean. And stay, as you say it with your chest. Stand up and say it strong, what you want. And just work hard for what you want.
He just has such a humbleness about him that it's like, even when you meet him in person, which like today was like my first time actually meeting him face to face, he's just like a big bubbly person. He's like, come give me a hug. Right. And you have a lot of people that, you know, maybe higher up, like in that atmosphere, like where, you know, you kind of feel like, oh, you know, because politics and government, a lot of times you come across politicians that are like, no, keep it right. So it's like to come across somebody that's like wants to embrace you and just that kind of energy, like it's just a beautiful experience to encounter somebody like that.
Indeed, it's been, I'm pretty sure, a pleasant carpet ride for you both.
Yes. Yes.
Ladies, you are both beautiful, and
Thank you.
Keep encouraging, keep fighting, and keep advocating as an individual and for a group.
Yes, ma'am.
We thank you all for being a part of this show today. And thank you all for being a part of the audience today. Yes. And we all want to thank you for being blessed with all the beautiful queens we've had on this program this evening. God bless everyone.
God bless.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Kimberly Harris, and I'm interviewing two beautiful queens today for the Journey of a Queen documentary. To my left here is the beautiful Queen Frederica Sellers.
Hello.
And also to my left is the beautiful Dr. Cheryl Cotter. Welcome to you both.
Thank you.
You're so beautiful, baby.
So are you. Thank you.
Thank you. So, I want you two beautiful queens to let me know how it came about that you gotten interested into this pageant.
Okay, so I was like browsing my Facebook one day and I actually got an inbox message from Jennifer. And at first I was like, me in a pageant. So I like sent her another message. I was like, did you mean to send this to me? And she was like, yeah, I'm waiting for your response. And I was like, oh, okay, sure. So that's how I got to know about the pageant.
Okay.
It's very exciting, very different.
I bet you were totally not the thing.
I wasn't that.
But that's okay.
Yes.
That's okay. And Dr. Carter, how did you become involved?
For me, it was actually my daughter. I was here to support her. She's also a part of the pageant. And just being here amongst the other beautiful queens, you know, it was an honor. And also, also advise that I should also be a part of it because I'm a woman, so why not?
That's heartfelt, ladies. Tell the listening audience a little bit of both of you about your individual backgrounds.
Okay, so I'm a business owner. The name of my business is called Genesis Transition. It's a life business, a life coaching business focusing on creative and career. I have authored 4 books. I'm currently writing book number 5. And when I'm not doing that, I'm working as an office manager at a dance studio in Beltsville, Maryland.
Oh, you're quite busy.
Yes.
Wow. Yes. That's impressive. And Dr. Carter?
I am actually an entrepreneur as well. I make all natural juices. It's called Juice for Life. And I got into it after I got fired working as a subcontractor, and just asking God, okay, God, I'm tired of not being in control. What do you want me to do? And he told me to go back to my purpose, which is in health and wellness and helping people to heal their bodies, get back into eating healthy. So that's how the natural juices made me making them got started.
So important. Health is so very important. As we know it today, it's so very important. We talk a lot about, or we hear a lot about, in social conversation about women supporting each other. What do you both feel on what unity means amongst women?
I think unity among women is very important because you can't do anything solo. There's always someone who can help you, and in there you can always help somebody else. So it's like you should grab hands. And as you're moving forward, someone should be pulling you, and whoever's behind you, you should be pulling yes. them like that. Because if you look in the Bible, like, there was really no solo person. David had Jonathan. I mean, Ruth had Naomi. Like, it's like almost like a mentorship in a way. So you should be pulling each other forward, not back. So unity is very important, especially in life.
That's awesome.
For me, I think we need to go back to the basics because it takes a village to raise a child. I mean, a village helped raise me, same, I had the same for my children. And this society has gotten so far away from it, and now the children appear to be so lost. That this next generation coming up, and they just need love. So if we go back to the basics of helping one another, build each other up instead of helping each other tear each other down, we can empower each other all over again and become the strong people that we want to be. We really are, but we just need each other to show each other how to get there.
We talk about leadership in the sense of inspiration, as we discussed prior. How has Dr. Frederick Newsome been a pillar, and what is he doing this process of this pageant? What has he brought out of you that was really hidden within inside of you? What has he brought to surface?
I recently just connected with Mr. Newsome, and just from interacting with him, he's a very positive Black male role model, which is something I think we need. Both young Black women and especially young Black men. Like, I have never seen, like, just seen on his social media, he's about the Lord, he's about community, things of that nature. And that's what's really needed right now, especially in this area, in this time frame. So I'm grateful that the Lord chose him to step up in this season to get things done that were not being done previously.
Dr. Palmer?
Aretha Franklin said it best, respect. You can be in leadership and be the worst person, but Dr. Newsome does not represent that. He represents respect, and definitely respect for women, where he's not one that exploits them. He's one that empowers women, and that is so far-fetched in today's society. So him as a leader at this time is phenomenal. It's what is needed because he's not for himself, he's for the people.
And that's so very powerful, and it's so very important to like that kind of leadership. Ladies, you both are inspirational vessels of beauty and honor, and I just privileged to have interviewed you both.
Oh,
good luck in your future careers.
Awesome.
Thank you so much for being with us today.
Thank you for the time.
At this time, we would like to take a pause to honor two of our queens who have lost their beloved children over the last year. Let us turn over a prayer to our beloved brother, Dr. Fred Newsome.
Amen. Everyone bow your heads, please. O gracious and eternal Father, Lord God, in the mighty and powerful name of Jesus, we thank you for your loving kindness and your tender mercy. We thank you, Lord God, for you being all-wise, all-knowing, and we know that you never make a mistake for you. Lord God, on this evening, we want to acknowledge two of our queens on tonight who children have went on to be in your amazing presence. Queen Paola Wilkins and her daughter, Adriana Leon, and Queen Danette Brown and her son, Stephen Dwayne Fields, Jr. God, we ask that you put a special blessing, a special prayer upon their lives. And Lord God, we know they're in your presence on today. And Lord God, to be present from here is to be present with you, Lord God. So we know when we leave this earth, we're in your presence. God, we ask that you comfort the hearts, souls, and minds of these amazing queens, Lord. And Lord God, let them know that you are all-powerful, you're all-knowing, and you have every answer in your hand, Lord. We ask that you comfort their hearts, souls, and minds. And Lord God, continue to bless them to move on in their journey, in life, Lord God. But just move them higher and higher, Lord God, in your will and in your purpose and in your intent in life, Lord God. God, we all thank you. We all praise you. We all magnify you. We thank you for this occasion, allowing us to come together, Lord God, and recognize these amazingly beautiful women, Lord God. But Lord God, we are your creation, and we want to humble ourselves before your mighty presence on today. Lord God, we praise you. We magnify you. We glorify you. And we ask you to continue to watch over and keep us, and forever let your face shine upon us. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.